And in spite of being lost, whenever she recalls and remembers the old days, she starts crying and becomes upset. So this is the basic unrestness within the spirit. He says that the Ruh, the king, when fell into the love of that nafs, then he bought her. The Ruh, the king, bought that handmaiden to win his desire. The king bought her to win his desire. When she came to his house under his control, then after some days, the king found that that handmaiden, his beloved, the nafs, herself has become ill. She has become ill. She has become extremely sick. Maulana Rum quotes an example saying he had a pitcher, but there was no water in it. And when he got the water, the pitcher was broken. He bought her to fulfill his desire. And when he started living with her, just he found that she became an extremely sick and ill. Her illness disturbed the king. And now the king called all doctors. He invited all doctors and tabibs and physicians to cure her, to treat her, to bring her back to health, because now his life is in her life and her life is in danger. The life of nafs is in danger. Now the Ruh is living for nafs, and nafs' life itself is in danger. Maulana Rum says,
Shahtabiba jama kar daz chapurast guft jane har do dar daste shumast.
The king gathered the physicians of his time together from right and left and asked and said to them that life of us, both of us, is in your hands. You should treat her. Now this is not matter of only her life, this is matter of my life too. If she is not cured and she dies, then I will die.
Jaane man sahlasto jaane jaanamu dardmando khastam darmanamust.
He says that my life is of no account, because she is the life of my life. When Ruh falls into the love of soul, love of nafs, since Ruh is pure, if it goes on the right path, it goes in a very beautiful way. And if it goes to the wrong path, because of its purity, it goes in a very speedy way. On both sides, her life is the life of my life, and not she. I am in pain, and I am wounded, and she is my remedy. If you cure her, so it means that I will come back to my life. And he says, whoever heals her, that is my life, will bear away with him my treasures and pearls and large and small, whatever I have, I will give him a lot. Whoever cures her. They all answered him saying, we will hazard our lives, we will try our best, we will put every possible effort of our intelligence and our experience and our ability, whatever, and we will stock our intelligence together, put together collectively, and we will try our best to
cure her and to bring her to her life.
And then they claimed, Maulana Rum says, every physician, each one claimed. What did they claim?
They said,
Hariyake Azma Masih Alamest Har Alam Ra Dar Kafe Ma Marhamest.
He says that every one of us is Messiah. This is the claim. Every one of us is like a Messiah of the world. And in our hand is every medicine for every person. He says, we are competent enough to cure her. Now you may think, why Maulana Rum has quoted these words and dialogue? He explains here that all those doctors and physicians who were called, and then just the next word, the next verse,
Akanizak Azmaraz Chumu Eshud Chashme Shah Az Ashke Chuju Eshud.
He says the more cures and remedies they applied, all possible medicines and treatments they applied, the more did the illness increase, and all remedies could not fulfill the need. Their treatment was completely failure. By this, Maulana Rum says that, oh, simple people of this world, all these physicians, what does he mean by the physicians? He said these were ulama'u zahir. And every alim of zahir claims, I am the messiah of the world. I am the biggest scholar of the world. I am the one having highest caliber of knowledge. I have answers to every question. I can cure every illness. I can do everything, whatever you want. So he says, these are the ulama'u zahir who claim. But if you give your illness in their hands for treatment, instead of curing you, they will make you more sick. And don't go in the hands of just ulama-e zahir. They are tabibane naqisa. They themselves are imperfect physicians. They never know the real diagnostic things. They have no treatment in their hand. They just give the speeches. They are just related to books and not related to the world of divine blessings. They are blind. They are arrogant. And in ilmu zahir, there is no treatment for nafs, no treatment for qalb, no treatment for ruh. So this is what Maulana Rum wants to give the message. And when the king understood that they have nothing to deliver, these, the ulama and the peers, who are in fact not the shuyukh, not salihin, not arifin, not ashikin, but they are just, they pose to be like that. And these ulama, naqisin, when he realized that they cannot cure my patient, then he went to Almighty Allah and fell in prostration and requested to Allah so that he may send some tabib-e-kamil, perfect physician for him. Sick girl became like a hair, thin as a hair, while the eyes of the king flowed with tears of blood like a river. And when the king saw that all these scholars and these tabibs and physicians and doctors, they are powerless, they are helpless. So he ran barefooted to the mosque. He entered the mosque and directly advanced to the mihrab to pray. He opened his lips. He praised Almighty Allah. He cried. And he said that, "O Allah," from depth of his soul, depth of his heart, he raised a cry, a supplication. And Almighty Allah gave him the sea of bounty. A sea of bounty began to surge for him. Almighty Allah started showering his blessing on him. Why? Because now he realized that my treatment is not in the hands of al-ulama, al-zahirun. There should be somebody else who could really treat me. Then Almighty Allah gave him his tiding. When he came back and he was sleeping, he saw a dream. And this was the answer and acceptance of his crying and his prayings. And he got a tiding, good news, that tomorrow you will see a stranger. He will come for you. And when he comes, you should understand that he is the skilled physician. He is the perfect physician. And you should trust in him. And I have given a magic in his hands. Now he comes to the Shaykh-e-Kamil. That the cure and treatment of these illness, spiritual illnesses, are not in the hands of those who are striving and struggling for the lusts of the world. Whenever the summer comes and these months come, lot many physicians come to England and come to States and come to Western world just for pounds, just for dollars, just for your pockets. And most of you people just receive them as they are perfect physicians. Allow them to stay in your houses and their eyes are always on your pockets, on the pounds, and they start giving you wazifas. And in the same way, then they have broadened their spectrum, expanded their spectrum. Instead of going from house to house, they have started sitting in the TV channel. And you are asking the wazifas and putting the questions, and they are solving your problem. This is how they say, everybody of us is a Masiha. Somebody is suggesting you to measure your clothes. Somebody giving you wazifa, close your eyes, do this, read this. And I want to tell you, nothing of all these silly things belong to tasawwuf and suluk and tariqa and marifa. This is just misguidance. These are money makers. And the people, the TV and channel owners who are doing this, they have nothing to do with the service of deen. This is just their business. They have to earn money. They may get from anywhere. Whether they get it from bringing a blame to deen or bringing a wrong name to tasawwuf and suluk and tariqa and marifa, whether to put deen and tasawwuf and suluk, mazallah, astaghfirullah, in hell, whether they can bring the singers or they can bring the dancers, or they can bring the magicians, or they can bring these characters. Doing damage to Allah's deen and Holy Prophet Sharia, and doing a great damage to marifa and tariqa and suluk. Suluk is this, what Maulana Rum has mentioned. This is tasawwuf. The awliya Allah, in 14, 13 centuries of Islam, never did and never recommended these silly kinds of acts which are being recommended through TV in the name of Sufi Baba and Peer online and I don't know what is happening over here.